For a maritime security expert, it is a necessary step for the Philippines to be vocal about China's aggression. Ray Powell of Stanford University's Gordian Knot Center for National Security Innovation says, well, it's not enough to deter Beijing. Manila's transparency will ultimately force China to recalculate its actions. He adds, making encounters with China public can help rally more international support for the Philippines.
The maritime militia is a particular problem for two countries in ASEAN, really the Philippines and Vietnam, and mostly the Philippines, frankly, simply because the Philippines has this really unique situation of not only having a Chinese naval port in its exclusive economic zone at Mischief Reef, but 30 kilometers away having an active blockade of one of its military outposts. There is nothing better for countering a gray zone actor than to turn the gray zone black and white. And these pictures do exactly that. Philippine government already has started to draw the line, right? Simply making all of these incidents public. These incidents are not unprecedented. They're just now public. And that's part of the government starting to draw the line.
Hundreds of foreign vessels, mostly Chinese, sighted in the West Philippine Sea. For the Chief of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, this highlights the need for the modernization of the military. Bianca Dava reports.
Armed Forces of the Philippines Chief of Staff General Romeo Bronner Jr. arrived at the Western Command Headquarters in Puerto Princesa, Palawan on Thursday, days after China's Coast Guard and militia vessels fired water cannons at the Philippine boat trying to resupply a military outpost in Ayungin Shoal. The WESCOM oversees a significant portion of the West Philippine Sea. Over 400 foreign vessels were sighted in the West Philippine Sea based on WESCOM's monitoring as of August 9.
Among EEC, in Westcom area lang, ha, mga 400 plus. That's my Chinese lang. Siguro mga 85% doon Chinese.
Bronner says this is why it's important to pursue the military's modernization program so it can deploy more assets to the West Philippine Sea.
Hindi lamang tayo nakafocus sa Ayungin, no? Sa Ayungin Shoal at sa BRP Sierra Madre. And marami rin tayo mga ibang mga isla na we are occupying, and we also need funds in order for us to improve the facilities there. So kailangan talaga natin na palakasin pa yung ating mga, yung presence, no, yung presence natin sa West Philippine Sea, and this would entail more funds.
Defense Secretary Gilberto Chudoro Jr. for his part expressed outrage over the Chinese Coast Guard's latest act of aggression. Teodoro says China is using the presence of EDCA sites to conceal its true intentions in the West Philippine Sea.
The Philippines will not bend over, as the president said, and we will not give in to unreasonable demands. And I think the narrative is being changed somehow, that it is a result of our engagements with the United States. I think the true intent of China in this incident is obvious. For me, I believe that the presence of Philippine bases with EDCA sites is being used as a cover for their true intent of dominating and exploiting the West Philippine Sea.
He also brands as an insult insinuations that the Philippines' actions are being influenced by the United States.
Ang layunin nito ay maglagay ng chismis sa bawat sektor ng society na pagwatak-watakin tayo. At pilit tayo, sinasama na lahat daw ng galaw natin ay pilit daw ng Estados Unidos sa atin. Sinasabi ko, insulto ito sa Republika ng Pilipinas. Tayo'y may sariling paninindigan.
He appeals to the public not to engage in speculation or to second guesses. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Palawan.
Members of the Philippine Navy share details of their latest encounter with China. Lieutenant Junior Grade Darwin Datwin says the Chinese ships tried to ram their vessel. He adds China's vessels came as close as 5 meters from the resupply boats.
Nasa 24 meters na po yung boats natin na pinagdala at nagpunta doon. May nagpunta po yun, sir.
So, and what was this, sir?
Ito lang po yung civilian chartered na po. Delikado talaga siya, sir, kasi yung mga bangka natin is made from wood. Anything na mangyari dyan na mabangka man yan or matamaan man yan ng matindi, hindi natin alam kung makakabalik pa talaga yung bangka na yan, kung abot na sila. So, very endangering talaga yung ginawa.
Meanwhile, Lieutenant Ramsey Gutierrez says the supplies they were supposed to deliver to troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre were ruined because of the water cannon incident.
Nabasa dahil mga bigas. Then yung ibang mga food provision is tinamaan din ng water cannon. So nagsabog-sabog mo yung mga nasirang food provision. Yung mga gulay, kape, yung mga panahon yun, ma'am. At that moment, ma'am, composed pa rin naman kami, ma'am. Then we are continuously coordinating with higher headquarters for the kung ano magiging action namin, ma'am. And to safely navigate lang yung mga chart boats natin. Na-backstream talaga siya, which is na-restrict na siya sa maneuverability. So there are two Chinese militia vessels on herport and starport, so kaliwat kanan, ma'am. And then yung Coast Guard vessel nasa likod naman, ma'am. So there is no choice for the boat to sail away from the intended track.
Philippine authorities vowing to bring justice to a teenager killed by police in Navotas City in a case of mistaken identity. Six police officers have been detained and are facing criminal and administrative charges over the death of Gerald Jemboy Baltasar. The 17-year-old was shot dead by police August 2nd after they mistook him for a murder suspect. Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos has ordered a review of procedures during police operations to avoid similar incidents from happening. PNP Chief Benjamin Acorda also visited the wake of Baltasar, assuring his family justice will be served.
Nandito lang ako para unang-una to extend our condolence at the same time to give assurance to the member of the family na wala tayong itatago dyan when it comes to the conduct of the investigation. We will be exerting all our effort na the truth will come out in the investigation.
The mother of the slain teen has arrived home from Qatar. Jeffrey Arnaiz now joins us with that story. Jeffrey, what more can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Radalisa Baltasar, the mother of a Jemboy Baltasar, the 17-year-old shot and killed by police after being mistaken for a crime suspect, has arrived in the country at exactly 10:43 a.m. Arriving via Philippine Airlines Flight 285 from Doha, Qatar, Radalisa was welcomed by Department of Migrant Workers Officer in Charge and Undersecretary Bernard Olalia, Migrant Workers Undersecretary Hans Cakdak, and OWA Chief Arnel Ignacio. Olalia said that Baltasar had been eluding Qatari authorities while engaging in different jobs since her departure from her employer the previous year. She sought assistance from the Department of Migrant Workers upon learning what happened to her son. Through her daughter, Baltasar's location was determined by a dedicated DMW team led by Doha Head Don Albert Pangkog. Following DMW's intervention and resolution of her case with the Criminal Investigation Department, she was given a final exit clearance. The DMW and the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration pledged a combined financial aid of 100,000 pesos. They will also oversee the repatriation costs and extend support for the funeral and burial expenses of the victim.
Philippine Vice President and Education Secretary Sara Duterte admits she did not review revisions to the new K-10 curriculum, citing her lack of background in the education sector. On Thursday, the Education Department launched the Matatag Curriculum, which is aimed at addressing issues hounding the current program. Duterte says she wants the new curriculum to be at par with other nations. That's why she relied on the expertise of the DepEd personnel.
I felt guilty kasi alam ko ako yung isa ako sa nag-cause ng stress because I do not come from the education sector. I do not have an education background, so I cannot review what they are doing. And I rely on their expertise and all the stakeholders who did the review. Ang magawa ko lang, which I do very well, admittedly, is magpukpuk talaga ng tao to drive a person to do what they are supposed to do.